So, looking down at your feet, making sure the toes are pointing forwards and your feet are spaced nicely. Bring your hands onto your hips and drop the shoulders. Just take a nice deep breath in. Lift the shoulders as you breathe in and breathe out and drop. Always has a nice feeling there. You're breathing in, lifting up into the shoulders. Breathe out and drop and let the air out. One more time, breathing in through your nose ideally and out through your mouth and drop through the shoulders. Good. So we'll sway from side to side like we usually start, just activating through the legs and getting those muscles, especially around your glutes, fired up a little bit. Talk to them, squeezing the glutes, talking to the muscles, making them work as you take your weight from side to side. And you may feel like coming upwards more is working. So you may feel like you've got a little bit more access to this. You've got your chest open, your chin tucked, neck lengthened up at the back. Fantastic. Rocking forwards and backwards through the toes, but make sure you don't grip with them too much. If you find yourself taking the weight through your toes and your toes start gripping, you're probably going a little bit too far. Forwards and backwards. Excellent. Lovely. Start sliding one arm down. See how far you can get with that arm. Remember, it's a little bit of a stretch up through the side of the body there, but it's also through that arm that you're stretching down. So if you push your fingertips down as far as you can, you'll feel a bit more of a stretch there. Good. Nice. Lovely. Turn your palms up. Drop through your shoulders, ribs down, shoulders down, hands out to the side, stretch your fingertips out to the side. Just pause for a second, check one side, check the other side, make sure the arms are relatively level and they're not behind you as well. Elbows in, hands back together. Good, go again. Hands out, arms out, elbows in, hands back together. Make sure you're tucked under and through here and the tummy's working. Hands, arms, brilliant. Keep going, thinking as you go about dropping the shoulders down. Think about tucking through the chin. Knees are a little bit bent and you've got some nice tension going on through the body. I say nice tension because I don't want you to brace and tighten, but that sort of fluid tension, if that makes sense. Good. Out, rotate down, rotate up. Elbows in, hands together, keep going. Out, out, rotate. Elbows, good. And you should feel all sorts of release going on, hopefully. Nice, we're going to rotate the body on the next one. So pause there, rotate just the body. Hips stay still, hips stay pointing forwards. Your headlights stay pointing forwards. To the front, elbows in, hands back together. Go again, hands out, arms out, rotate. Good, elbows in, hands back together. Good, keep going. Nice. And again. One more each side. Good. And last one. Lovely. Keep with your palms here. Stretch forwards, wide, forwards, back in. We're going for a bit of endurance through the arms today, I've decided. Forwards, wide, forwards, in. Good, keep the shoulders down. Good, so you don't need to lift heavy weights to tone through the arms. You can get lots of lovely toning and strengthening and stability through a lot of these movements that are not even weighted. Although I'm thinking of bringing back the tin cans. Although we bought them all at the beginning of lockdown, they were all in our cupboards, we didn't use them, and if you're anything like me, I gave them away for Harvest Festival in the food banks. So I don't actually have any tins in my cupboards anymore. Good. Okay, palms facing forwards, and then we're doing that half circle there, rainbow shape. Thank the NHS with your rainbows. Try and draw as big a arc as you can, keeping your arms straight. Good. Palms facing down, circle backwards. Think about the rest of your body for a second. Your feet on the floor, your arches lifted, your knees a little bit bent, your bottom tucked under. We can all help with the stability with this one. Circle back the other way. Dropping the shoulders, feeling around those shoulder blades. Maybe that's working. It's a good area to work. Fantastic. Arms up. We're going to pretend we've got weights in our hands, so we're going to do triceps. Good. If we do 20 of these, we'll feel them. 4, 5, 6, 7. 10, so that's halfway. You might feel a little bit of warmth going on there. 2, 4, keep breathing. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Bring the arms down, pulsing backwards. Keep those ribs down though. I just noticed with me, my ribs popped up. So keep the ribs down, stretch the arms back and pulsing backwards there. Again, using those triceps a little bit. Keep breathing. 4, so in and out like that. You'll not be able to touch your hands together unless you're a little bit anatomically different to me. Who knows? So you should feel a little bit of burn going on through the arms there. A good burn, hopefully. Stretch up with your right arm, down with your left, and bend your knees and sink down into it. Draw in the tummy. Good. Scooping around. Big arc again. Lots of arcs. To the front. And curl your way back up. Drop the shoulders. Other arm up. Down. Bend your knees. Good. Everything pointing forwards. Lovely round. To the front, and curl back up. Breathing in, all the way up to the top, up onto the toes. Breathing out, hands behind your head. Breathe in, lift your shoulders. Breathe out and drop. Breathe in, stretch up. Out, round and down. And one more of those, breathing in. All the way to the top. Breathe out, hands behind your head. Breathe in, lift your shoulders. Breathe out and drop. Breathe in, stretch up. Round and down. Good. Now then, so this exercise that we've worked on a few times, but I think I missed it out the last few times. Take the weight onto your left side. Stretch that right leg forwards. Sideways, behind you. Remember, top tips. Forwards, you can kind of go as far as you like. Sideways, hips level. Backwards, keep your back strong and don't let the leg go too far. Good. And go again. Forwards, keep going on the same side. Side, back, forwards, side, back. These aren't big heavy ankle weights, by the way, that go all the way up my legs. They are leg warmers to keep me warm. Side, back, so I don't have to put all my heating on just for me. Good. Last one. No doubt I'll get too hot during this session though. Take the weight onto your right leg. Tighten, squeeze through your tummy, hips level. Straight leg. Scoop it forwards. Sideways, behind. Forwards. Side, behind. Good, keep going. Forwards. Lovely. One last one. Brilliant. And we'll go from doing that very blocked backwards movement to the RDL, which is forwards like this. And remember, it's the standing leg that we're doing the work on. So everything forwards, bottom tucked under, something to put your fingers on next to you if you want to. Coming forwards. 1. Good. Squeeze in. 2. Everything forwards. 3. 5, let's do 10, 6, 7, 8, 2 more, And sometimes it's when you stop that you feel the back of that leg turning around the other way. Good. Everything tucked in. Forwards. I knew I was going to hit that sofa. One. Good. Two. Three. Drop the shoulders. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Good. Slow it down if you need to. Eight. Nine. Ten. Lovely. All right. Legs wide, toes pointing out. Good. Hands again on your hips. What? And back up. Tailbone heading straight down towards the floor. Drop the shoulders, tuck the chin. Good. Eight, two more. Ten, arms straight up. Tap the floor and back up. Two, squeeze everything on the way back up. Three, four, five, six. Don't banana the body backwards, we're just coming upright. Seven, we're just doing 10, so three more. Last one. Brilliant. Okay, so on to the end of your mat. Toes forwards. Drop the shoulders. Breathe in, breathe out, and feel yourself from the top of your spine curling down. So just the neck first, and then it's your upper back. Your upper back curls in that direction anyway, but as soon as you get to the bottom of the rib cage, you need to scoop in here and curl through the spine all the way down to the bottom. Good. Let those arms go heavy. Let your head go heavy. Good. Breathing in. Breathing out, try to sink a little bit further down. And again, breathing in. Breathing out and sinking down into it. Bend and straighten alternate knees, feeling how that brings you that little bit further down. Good. Take your left arm and reach up and round. Quite nice to breathe with it again. Breathe in. Breathe out and stretch around with your right arm. Good. Breathe in. Put your left arm just on your hand on your lower back and rotate round with the elbow. See if that feels any better. And then the other way, put the right hand on your lower back and stretch around with the elbow. Good stuff. Bending your knees, coming forwards onto your hands and knees. Rocking forwards on your wrists, just stretching those wrists out. Elbows locked straight. I'm hearing about lots of wrist problems now. Now these different working conditions have been in place for a little while. It's getting quite common to have these wrist problems, lower arm problems. So we've got to look after them. This is one way. Good, stretching the hand over one at a time, but lock the elbow. That's where you're going to get a nice stretch through that forearm. Good. And stretch the other. Pull the shoulders down away from the ears at the same time. Good. Both hands on the mat. Make sure your hands are underneath your shoulders and your knees are underneath your hips as well. With the shoulders, we're going to drop and lift. Good. This is one that I find I end up correcting quite a lot in classes. So make sure you drop your chest down towards the floor and then pull your chest up and away. Drop the chest down and pull up and away. Good. Not moving with your chin. We're not heading down with the chin.
here, can we lower down onto the elbows and then push up onto the hands again? Let's do five each arm. Right, left, right up, left up. Draw in the tummy. Good. And then we're going to do the same on the other side. We're kind of doing a bit of a single arm press up there. Three. Keep the tummy strong. Five. Lovely. Right leg out. There. Take a moment to draw in the tummy and make sure everything's nice and strong. And then we're just pulsing up and down, toe tap and lift. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. And in. Other leg. Stretch out and pulsing up, making sure you've got that connection at the front that is not allowing your back to arch and the knee is locked. Good. Out to the side. I'm going to do my left leg first so you can see. Sideways. But think about that tray of drinks on your back that you're not going to let drop off by rocking the back to the side. Okay, so drawing the tummy. And one, two, three, four, seven, eight, nine, ten. Lovely. And the other side. One, two, three, four, seven, eight, nine, ten. Good stuff. Sit back on the heels and then pull up onto your hands and knees again. So we're going to do 10 of these. Sitting back. Two. Three. Use your tummy to come back up and the shoulders strong. Good. And then we're going to come down onto our fronts. And we're going to do some sort of push-ups from here and back extensions. So we're going to push as far as we can and down. I've got my my fingertips pointing in and vaguely underneath my shoulders, but my elbows are pointing right out. Okay. Two. Three. Keep your tummy a little bit strong. Four. Elbows don't have to straighten the whole way. Five, six, seven. I give these out all the time for back pain. Ten. Lovely. Come down onto your front now and make a bit of a pillow for your forehead. With your right leg, you are going to point the toe and bring the heel towards your bottom, and then flex, and then point. And then down, the other leg, bottom tucked under. Good. Flex, point, and down. Swap. Point. Flex, point, and down. Flex, point, and down. Good, keep going. You're not going to feel a lot going on here, but it really trains your middle to stay put as you're doing something else with the rest of the body. Pull the shoulders down away from the ears and keep your tummy strong and your bottom tucked under. Good. One more each side. And last one. Lovely. Okay, pushing back up so we can turn over. Okay. Heels on the floor, up tall, draw in the tummy, elbows nice and wide, curl back elbows together, pull up and open out through the chest. Two, three, up tall each time. Four, think about being squashed like a spring.
and then pulling up tight. Good. Two more. Lovely, legs straight. Come down, just easing down forward, stretching through the back. Breathe into it. Good. Hands behind your head, bend your knees again. Curl back elbows together, open out to one side. One, two, three, five, six, seven. Great stretch, this one. Eight. Two more. Ten. Fantastic. Coming down onto the back. This is where you can relax briefly because it's been quite speedy so far, the class. Tuck through your chin. Broaden and open out through your chest. Breathe in, breathe out, and sink the ribs down. Make sure you maintain that broadness of the chest there. Tilting and rocking the pelvis a few times backwards and forwards. Settle with a little arch, and therefore your pelvis is rocked in that direction, tilted forwards, sticking your bottom out a little bit to create that little arch. Tighten through your pelvic floor and then lift and lower one leg at a time. Good. Ultimately, with no control around your pelvis, you would flatten your back each time you lift up the leg there. I'm hoping that most of you have been doing my classes regularly, so I'm hoping that that's resulted in more control around here, so it's less likely that you will flatten your back as you're doing this. But if you want to check, you can stick your fingertips underneath, and if you don't feel any flattening there, that's good. Good. Lovely. Lowering one knee sideways, back up, and then the other side. Drawing your attention to your stable leg, the leg that is not moving. That's the one that's doing the work, believe it or not. You're pushing down gently into it. You're tightening up through that leg and in and across your middle. Good. Ribs are down, tummy in. Keep breathing. Lovely. Right leg to tabletop. Stretch it away with your thighs level. Back in and down. And then the other leg. Up, out, in, down. In, down. Good. Pushing down into the floor each time. Breathing nice and relaxed. Last one. Nice. And then before we move on to the next level, where we actually activate those outer muscles a little bit more, it's nice to do something to activate them. So we're going to do a set of hundreds. Tuck the chin, crunch up, push your fingertips down towards your toes, and beat your hands up and down like so. Squeezing in through your pelvic floor because this causes lots of pressure downwards. Good. And maintaining that little arch in the lower back as you go, so you're not flattening your back to go. You've got an arch at the same time. Right hand behind the head, left up and down. So you can support your head now with that right hand. Make sure it encourages your chin into a tuck. Good, now swap sides. Other arms stretching down and pulse up and down.
Good, good. If you can handle it, stay in that crunch and let's go from side to side. It's the neck that maybe you will be a little bit aware of. Good, three, two, one. Brilliant, and come back down. Lovely. Relax your head by rotating from side to side a couple of times. Make sure that hasn't got too achy and grippy. Good. So using those muscles that we've just woken up there at the front here, pick up the right leg, draw in your tummy, pick up the left, right down and left down. Good. Reset your position. Tuck your chin, open the chest, ribs down. Up, up, down, down. Get the feeling that all of this is stable and still and drawn in. Good. Breathe in through your nose, out through your mouth. Great. And let's start with the other leg first. It's quite good to have a little jiggle, think about resetting your position, arch in the back, tighten through the pelvic floor and start with the other leg, drawing in your tummy. Good. Four. Seven. Eight. Two more. Good, little leg shake, breath, and out again. Good, so let's do a few crunches just to go from here, make sure we don't get too tight around the thighs and the hip flexors, to then lifting the head and shoulders off. So hands behind your head, drop the ribs, squeeze in the tummy, and go. Two, three, four, seven. Backs of the hands touch the mat each time. With the right leg up for just five. One, three, four, five. Bring that leg down, pick up the other one, and off we go. One, two, four, five. Nice. Legs down, breathe. Okay, so we're gonna have both legs in tabletop. Draw in your tummy, tap the toes, tap and lift, scoop in the tummy. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Sideways with one leg, one, and then the other leg. Two. Five, keep those ribs down. Nine, 10, then stretch out. One, two, straighten the leg all the way each time. Seven, eight, nine, 10. Lovely, nice little series there. Roll the knees from side to side. Bring the legs down. Good, give them a little shake. Bring your heels close to your bottom and then lift your heels up off the floor. So we're up on our toes for these shoulder bridges today. Hands on the ribs, tucking under, curling up, pushing the knees away, squeezing your tummy. Make sure you don't arch your back. Whoa, so much information. Ribs down, curl down. Good, tucking under, curling up, push your knees away. Don't arch your back. Good. Squeeze at the front to curl your way back down again. One more. Tucking under, curling up, push your knees away. Don't arch your back. Good. Can we drop one knee sideways? Two, three, four, five,
Are your feet forgiving enough to do this? Are your calves forgiving enough? One more each side. Curl back down.
Oh my gosh, that made me jump. Guinea pigs. Ooh, can you see them?
Just starting running around. Hold on behind the right leg. Stretch up and down. Toes flexed. So this is for your hamstrings after that last exercise. 4, 5, 6, 8, 10. Bring your foot down and then the other side. Hold on behind. Flex the foot. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 10. Brilliant. Last abs exercise. So this one is difficult. So if you know that you find the abs a little bit difficult, maybe just head back and do a few crunches or just a few stretches. So hands behind your head, legs up to tabletop. In a crunch, straighten out your right, rotate to the left. Come back to the center and stop. 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9. Then let's get another 10 in. 1, 2, 3. Keep working that pelvic floor. 6, 7, 8, 9. There, nice one. Bring your knees in. So we have a few minutes to get some glutes done, even though we did loads of them in standing. So I don't mind skimping on these very slightly for this bit. Tuck the hips back. Scoop and tuck your bottom under. Push your top hip away. And let's do 10 lifts here. Don't rock the top hip back. 7, 8, 9, 10. Feet up. 1, 3, 4, 5, 8, 9, 10. Bottom leg down, squeezing in and back. 2, 3. Nice and controlled with everything else working. 7, 8, 10. Fabulous. Bring that leg down. Other side. So like I say, a bit tame on these glutes today, but we did do a lot in standing at the beginning. Good, good. Tuck the ribs back. Tuck the hips back. Scoop and tuck your bottom under. Feet together and in line with your bum. 1, 2, 4. 10, the hands on your hips to stop that top hip rocking back. Bring up your feet. 1, 2. Much harder to rock the hips back in this position. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Bottom leg down, holding onto that hip helps you to keep strong through there. 7, 8, 2 more. Lovely, and probably just enough time to get some stretches in. So sitting up, crossing your legs, and bending forwards into it. There, pushing the knees down with your hands there. Good, and that should get you right on the side of the glutes, which is where we've just worked. The gluteus medius, which is the stability muscle of the glutes rather than the power muscle. Great. And another way to stretch this, if we just come straight down onto our sides and stretch that top leg out, we can just roll over onto it. Don't worry that you're a bit twisted and rotated there. We don't have to come right down on top of it. We can have the hip down, and in fact, that gives you a better stretch. And then we will swap sides. a little bit awkward to stretch that leg back and bring the other one underneath, but you can see maybe on this side a little bit more that I have my hip down there, and that actually helps with that glute stretch. Great. So we've got our glutes stretched out. We're going to come onto our fronts again there. Bend one knee and stretch through the quads, tucking your bottom under, pushing your knee away a little bit and keeping your knees quite snug together, pulling your heel towards your bottom. Very nice. And swap legs. Good. Heel to your bum. Coming onto your hands and knees. Fall back this time, up and down. Try to go to the extreme of each. Five. Lovely. Step one leg up in front. Hook your hands together and stretch up. Good. Lunge a little bit further into it for a few more seconds. Come back halfway to here. Point and flex the foot. And then sit down on your heel. That's a little bit of a different stretch there. My heels and ankles don't like that too much. Good. And stepping the other leg up. Hook the hands together again, stretching up, tucking your bottom under. So that should be quite a specific stretch in the front of the hip there. Good. Lunging forwards then for a bit. Takes a bit of balance actually, this. Coming back halfway, point and flex the ankle. Come back all the way, sitting on the heel. Feel that slightly different stretch through the back of the leg, hamstring. Good, good. Hands and knees again. Toes tucked under. Bottom stretched up. Drop the shoulders back. Or forwards. Back or forwards. Chest forwards. Chest towards the feet. Bending each knee, pushing each heel down to the floor, stretching that calf. I don't care who you are, this will always feel tight. Good. Walking your hands to your feet. Breathe in, breathe out and sink down. Let the head go. Good. Curl your way up. And one last little stretch, stepping the legs out, bringing your elbows down onto your knees, pushing the legs out, stretching that inner thigh. Okay, good work. So I hope you enjoyed that. Slightly different today.